Memorial Stadium in Lincoln, holding more than 81,000 fans. It's the third largest city in Nebraska on game day. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. Northwestern is ready to open this one up as they line up for the opening kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Run, and he's brought down. Bryant picks up about 7 yards on the run. They go with the run, and he's taken down behind the line.
I think anytime you lose yardage, it's frustrating. As a ball carrier, it's very frustrating as a play caller. Makes you a little bit more hesitant maybe to go back to a certain play. The biggest thing you want to do as an offensive coordinator is get the offense over to the sideline after the series, make sure everybody's on the same page, and then show the confidence that you still have in them despite this play that you're going to go right back to the running back and trust that offensive line. That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
He's tackled at about the 49. And he hits him hard at the 39-yard line. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
Just gets rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Hands it to the back. Tackle made at the 38-yard line. He wants it all, going long. It's knocked away, incomplete.
Well, you want to do everything you can to keep the ball out of the hands of these receivers, so that was a really good effort.
They call on the kicker for a long field goal. Nebraska could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks up. No good. He missed it to the right. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Gives it to the back. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. To the tailback, incomplete. Third down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 39. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. They'll bring him down at the 38.
When you can move the ball downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want them.
And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five receiver look. Brought down at the 28.
Come on, D.
Mike five.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. They went back to the same play that time.
Yeah, you're right. Same play as the one before, and they got a good completion and a nice gain.
They'll spread the field with five wide. Gets it. He's in space. Steps out of bounds. Right around the 16-yard line. Open field. He goes out of bounds at about the 13. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Throws complete. He's got space to work. Big play, and it's first and goal. 10th play of the drive. He's tackled at the 2-yard line. Quick throw, caught, touchdown. To his wide receiver, who made the grab and got the score.
When this guy's got time to throw, he makes the defense pay.
He makes the PAT. So a 10-play, 62-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
So our score, 7-0. He's to the 20, across the 30, and they push him out around the 37-yard line. Northwestern's looking right now like they've got all three phases working for him so far.
Yep, it's early, but they are in control of this game. The defense seems to have a very good feel for what they're doing out there. The offense moved the ball down the field. Special teams, everything right now is really in sync for this team.
And they get nice yardage on that run. Gets it out quickly. He's pushed out of bounds. Right around the 50. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
Quickly to the tight end, incomplete. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 50-yard line. Tackle at the 47. He passes it. Almost intercepted. He's going to aim this one to the sideline, try to kick it out of bounds. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. Wildcats offense, I thought, answered the doubters big time with an impressive opening drive, and they got on the board first.
Yeah, when you're in a hostile environment, you want to play with a little bit of a chip on your shoulder and just show people that you're not intimidated by the environment. They sure did that first time out.
Northwestern up 7 points. And he's taken down at the 31.
Take four.
comes the screen, and they can't connect. From their own 31-yard line, second down. And he's level at the 26. From their own 26-yard line, it's third down. Going deep, lays it out there, and he's got it. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 19. Tries to buy some time. He's taken down at the 11.
Nice play, baby. Nice play.
Let's go, D. Let's go.
High five. High five.
Hey, go. Mark says it's the line. Take four. Take four.
Touchdown, Northwestern. Great call by the offensive coordinator.
Big time play, taking that ball all the way in. Maybe the defense wasn't expecting a run.
And he converts the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Wildcats are looking downright scary on defense so far, Irby.
They are flying around as a group right now, completely aware of what this offense is trying to do and dismantling them every single time on every single play.
You know they'd like to do something a little more than they did on their last drive when they had to punt the ball away.
They've been beaten soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter.
Make the stop at the 32-yard line.
No, here we go, here we go.
He gets to about the 41-yard line. So at the end of one quarter, the Wildcats lead 14-0. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two.
Tight end right. Three down, three down. Hey, check my
quick out to his receiver. And down he goes at the 47-yard line. He's under pressure. Wideout makes the first down catch. He's tackled at the 34. Looks to his receiver, first down. Quickly to the tailback. Tackle made at the 20. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Ready.
Gets it to his wide receiver, and he's got another one.
Well, on third down, we expected them to go to the air, and they did just that, picking up the first down.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver.
That's just a great play to separate the ball from the receiver. He'll be feeling that hit tomorrow.
Here's the 11th play of the drive. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Here's the pitch, left side. Touchdown, Cornhuskers!
It takes a lot of strength to run it when you're hitting into a massive pile of bodies. Good job of holding on to it and getting it across the goal line.
And he tacks on the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Northwestern is up 7. Taken down in the backfield. The defense was all over that draw play.
And they got very good containment on the halfback. He had nowhere to go with the football.
Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on their own 23. On the delay, and he's brought down immediately. He's going to go for the home run. He's hit and taken down. Looks to the back and can't connect. From the 40-yard line, it's second down. They'll bring him down around the 20-yard line. They'll knock him down for a loss. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 20-yard line. He has some room. They go to the left for a nice gain. Northwestern is up by a touchdown. Strike to the receiver. Lost the ball. Fumble.
It's not like receivers don't practice hanging onto the ball all week. This is just a case of the defense creating a turnover.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. They line up in the jumbo set. Nice run up the middle. Lee with the play fake, zips it to the back. Brought down at the 16. had some steam on that throw.
And he's tackled
around the 24-yard line. They bring him down in the backfield. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four.
Three down.
45's the mic.
Red 68.
Tackle at about the 29-yard line. It complete over the middle,
and he's taken down at the 30. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there,
and that's because the defense was just waiting on it and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Quick pass. He's to the 40. He's taken down around the 45-yard line. Makes a grab and steps out right away.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
Knocked out of bounds around the 30-yard line. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Makes the catch, and look out. And he hits him hard at the 21-yard line. And they make the stop around the 17-yard line. Nebraska will have one timeout remaining. Second and six. Ball on the 17. They get him in the backfield for a loss. And down he goes, right around the 18-yard line.
I think the play call was the right one by the offense. I just think the defense made a better play. They seem to want it more here on this big third down. Offense comes up a little bit short to set up a fourth down, but give all the credit to the personnel on the defensive side of the ball.
Kicks away, and it is good. Brown has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Last time the offense had it, they lost a fumble. So I'm pretty sure the coaching staff was over there talking about ball security.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
Fires out to his wideout. He's tackled in the open field. First and 10. Ball on the 35.
Good job by the offensive line to pick up the linebacker on the blitz. That gave the quarterback enough time to find his man for a nice game.
He steps out around the 39-yard line. Northwestern is up by four.
He gets rid of this one.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Third down and 7. Ball on their own 39. Let's it fly. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
About the 37-yard line.
Second and 5 coming up here.
Ball on the 37.
The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts.
There's a strike complete. Tackle made at the 30-yard line. They'll spread the field with 5 wide.
We played a half of football. The Wildcats lead 14-10.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game.
I'm sure both teams had problems in the first half, but one of them, David, not moving the football. Both offenses really ran up and down the field.
We see this more in college football, Reese. More success on the offensive side, and it's harder and harder to stop these offenses that continue to get more and more complicated. The defenses, they got no answer. They got to find an answer quick, or else this ball game is just going to go tick for tack the whole second half.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, brother. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin.
He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again.
Northwestern holds a 4-point lead.
He fights forward to about the 26.
Makes it out to about the 27-yard line. Going long. He almost had it, but it's incomplete. Williams is back deep to return. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. He's taken down at the 36.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
Throws in a hurry. And he's got the junior at the 30. And they finally knock him out at the 18. Gains his way to the 10-yard line.
And he makes it out to about the 8-yard line. And they got him for a loss. This should be an easy field goal. It's up, and he's got it.
And you gotta think they're pretty happy with holding him to a field goal right there.
They line up to kick this one away. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 24. Let's see if this drive has a more rewarding conclusion than their last, which ended with a punt. Northwestern with a one-point lead. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Throws complete. He's got room to work. They'll bring him down at the 39-yard line. Flag down, and I'm not sure when it was thrown. Let's find out. That one will put the offense in a hole, and they'll try to get some of that back on this upcoming play. So it's second down and 15 after the penalty. He's going to try and scramble, and he's sacked. He throws right. And they're going to have to bring on the punt team.
It was a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
The punt upcoming, and they're going to come after this one. Williams fields at the 42, tackle at the 47. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage. Decent pickup. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. They get nice yardage on that run. Nice run, and he's brought down. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 20. To about the 17-yard line. Check down.
quick throw. The ball pops free. It's picked up by the offense. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Fires quickly, and they got it. Touchdown. Well, they're going to try for the two-point conversion. And they get the two. So a 9-play, 47-yard drive. And they add 8 to the scoreboard after that successful two-point conversion. So the score now, 21-14. Brown ready to kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. And he tackles him hard at the 37. Gets past the tackler. He gets hit out of bounds.
Right around the 44-yard line.
Larry, Larry. Tighten up. Tighten up. Pull together.
Hey, kill, kill, kill.
X7. Where? He's coming.
Now he tries to buy some time. And he's level at the 47-yard line. So it's second down and 13 yards to go following that quarterback sack. He gets sacked on the play. Guns it left side. He goes out of bounds at the 39. It's fourth down. They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. He gets it up. No good. He missed it to the left.
Well, sometimes when you see a kick like that, the kicker is trying to compensate for a factor, maybe like the wind, and he thinks he can hook it back in. It didn't happen that time.
Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Nebraska up 7 points. Tackle right around the 38-yard line.
Too easy, too easy.
Second down and 11. Ball on the 38. So at the end of three, the Cornhuskers lead 21-14. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action.
Three down.
Gives it off. Nice run there. Incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Nagel is back deep to return the punt. He really got a hold of that one.
He takes it at the 12.
Oh, he got nailed on that one. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Here's a run.
He's on the run.
Out of bounds. Around the 37-yard line. Fights forward to about the 39.
Nice play, baby. Nice play. Double tight.
Easy.
Easy.
20.
He's on the run. Brought down around the 41-yard line. Throws it away.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. It's away, and it's a booming punt. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Nebraska is up by a touchdown. And he's taken down at the 43-yard line. Takes it right side for a good game. And they make the stop at about the 41. Taken down at the 29. Throws complete and he's hit right away. Thrown. I don't think he got anything on that. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker.
Go nowhere, 22. Go nowhere.
Hey, check Mike 45. Check Mike
45. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Picked up a first down on that carry.
Yeah, a good job up front by the offensive line. They picked up some nice blocks to allow that back to get in there for some extra yardage.
He gets out to about the 8. Nebraska is up a score. Six-yard line. Quick release. Tight end, incomplete.
That's a miscommunication between a quarterback and a wide receiver right there. They need to get their signals straight.
Here's the 11th play of the drive. And he shoved out of bounds right around the 2-yard line. Touchdown.
Don't think that this isn't huge. The game's not quite over, but boy, have they put themselves in a great spot.
And he converts the extra point. So a 12-play, 78-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Caught, open field. He's knocked out of bounds at about the 29-yard line. Quick out to his receiver. He's tackled around the 38-yard line. He's tackled at about the 47-yard line.
Kill, kill. Panther 2.
Ship, ship.
They got 9.
Good open field tackle.
Kill, kill, kill.
Gunner 3.
Red 2. Blue 20. Go.
Tackle made the 37-yard line. They'll bring him down around the 31-yard line. A lot of concern from his teammates with a guy down on the field.
Hey, kill, kill, kill! Black 5, black 5!
Slings it, and he's stopped behind the line. This is the 8th play of the drive.
Fight five, fight five.
Under a minute left in the game.
Easy, easy.
And he's going to come up with a sack.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you definitely are going to feel it the next day.
Fourth and long here after the sack. They come out in a 5-wide set. Going deep. He makes the PAT. And he's tackled at the 40-yard line. And we see this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game, and it helped them get the score. Let's see if they can do it again.
Bryant comes away with 5 yards on the carry. From the 35-yard line, it's second down.
He fights forward to about the 33. A yard, maybe two on the carry. Northwestern will use their final timeout. He gets to about the 24-yard line. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. A great game here today in a tight one. 28-21, Cornhuskers. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.